Hello everyone, welcome to the Jyotishi YouTube channel. Today we are going to discuss on the importance of lighting a lamp in the puja room.
So Anand, as a child, you know, I always used to wonder why people light a lamp, right? Whenever I used to see my dad or my mom perform a puja in the puja room, yes. I always used to wonder what is the significance behind lighting a lamp. Now, can you enlighten us a little more about what is the significance behind lighting a lamp before you offer your prayers?
So, we have five Panchamahabhutas. One is Agni Deva, Vayu Deva, Jala Devi, Bhumi Devi and Narayana. So, out of which Agni is a medium which kind of translates our prayers and offerings to the Almighty. So Agni is historically known as a medium, and it is regarded as a supreme light. So when we say supreme light, so Agni has extensive mention in the Vedas, especially the Rig Vedas. There are a lot of hymns in praise of Agni. And Agni represents, or the light represents, victory of light over darkness, wisdom over ignorance, and knowledge over evil.
Okay.
So Agni generally represents a pure consciousness state from that perspective. So you said, right, your parents, you watched your parents. So ideally, we have to be blessed to be watching our parents lighting the lamp. So there are many cases where, in today's scenario, where even parents don't know, or parents don't even bother about, you know, kind of lighting the lamp. So unless the parents light, the children will absolutely have no idea about lighting and, you know, praying to God and those kind of stuff.
Okay. So going back a few sentences, right? So you also spoke about moving from darkness to light, or
yes,
moving from ignorance to wisdom.
Yes.
How does the fire element, yes, right, or the Agni Tattva help us trigger that knowledge within us? Or how does it help us move from darkness to light? Or how does it help us move from ignorance to wisdom?
Yes. So, ideally, when we light the lamp, we usually chant a prayer. Shubham karoti kalyanam, bhagyam dhanam sampadah, shatrubuddhi vinashaya, deepar jyoti namostube. So, actually, we are praying to Agni, praying to light, which is the supreme soul. And then we are telling the Agni that, you know, dhanam, dhanyam, dhanam, and that is wealth, and then prosperity, please bring that into our lives. And then let the light kind of bring in goodness all over the world, kind of a thing. So, Deepar Jyoti Parabrahma. So, Deepar Jyoti is actually equated with the Parabrahma. So, Deepar Jyoti is also Janardhana. And then it can be chanted right in the morning and in the evening also. So it kind of creates a vibration which kind of purifies the system. So you would have seen in age-old houses where in the mornings, especially in the evenings, they light this lamp and then they go out and say Deepam. So it kind of our, you know, grand mothers and ancestors used to say it kind of eliminates negativity. So yeah, there are different kinds of negative elements that come out in the evening, especially in the sunrise and the sunset times. So it they usually go out and then chant Deepam, this chant, and then kind of purify the atmosphere, kind of thing.
So the sun is also a source of fire, right?
Yes.
It is also one of the biggest Agni Tattvas, which is also responsible for life on earth.
Yes.
So how is there a correlation between, you know, the sun and also us using the Agni Tattva during the time of prayers?
So sun represents the light energy and Agni represents the heat energy. So both these elements are very critical in our day-to-day routine. So we have different lokas. We'll take that up in another session, where we have Bhur Bhuvars, Swarga Loka and all that. So the Bhur Loka is ruled by Agni. So, and hence it is important for us to kind of pray to Agni on a daily basis, or at least light the lamp and then pray and chant this mantra. So it's very important from that particular perspective.
Is there also a correlation, you know, between lighting a camphor? They say when you light the camphor and do an aarti, it also brings in a lot of positive energy into the into the atmosphere. And this is scientifically proven, where they say that there are certain eons that are, you know, transmitted in the atmosphere, where the entire atmosphere also gets purified.
Exactly.
Similarly with using ghee, right? One of the reasons why ghee is used is they say that 1 tablespoon of ghee used in a lamp or used to light your daily aartis also purifies the energy.
Exactly.
Can you maybe throw some light on this?
Yes. So now counter question comes. The so-called scientific people, they ask, if light is so important, why don't we just light the bulb and then keep it kind of a thing? So the basic principle is, oil represents our vasanas. So vasanas means our negative tendencies in life. And the vik represents our ego. So as the light emerges, or as the diya lights, or as the vilak lights in the bowl or in the copper bowl,
in the lamp,
our vasanas and our viks or the egos kind of decreases, and it kind of leads us to a pure spirituality kind of a space. So that is exactly what happens when we light a lamp. So when we light a lamp, although it's a symbolic representation, the vasanas, the negative tendencies move out, and our ego kind of reduces, and that's exactly what we want to do in our life. So become humble, more humble in life, and then try to move on in, from that perspective.
Right. So doing this every day is also one form of realization that you should move beyond your egos and your vasanas and move towards that positive self that you want.
Yes.
It's also maybe trying to remember that you move in that direction.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So that is what we are trying to do here.
And try and connect with the Almighty through a medium called Agni, so that our kind of soul is kind of reasonably purified, and then we move ahead in the right direction.
So since you spoke about purification, so even Agni, the Agni Tattva is also known as a purifier.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So a lot of homas, this is slightly going away from the topic of lighting a lamp, but a lot of homas are done to purify the atmosphere that you are in, right? So when you like when you go into a new house, or when you get married, all of these homas are done also as a purification element that basically purifies the atmosphere around.
So a lot of research is being done from that perspective, where Agni is kind of used as a medium where it purifies the atmosphere. I'm purposely not getting into the scientific area, because the focus here is only on belief. So there are two aspects to it. So one is science, one is belief. So spirituality from the core comes due to belief. So there are many things that science cannot prove, there are many things that science can prove. But spirituality is an experience. It is more to, it is not an experiment, a medium and an experiment kind of a solution. It's more to do with your feelings and emotions and your connections with the reality.
Right.
And Agni is one of the best mediums to kind of take you to that path of spiritual journey.
Okay.
Because after all, it's the light,
which
is called the spirit or the soul or whatever it is.
Right. So belief or faith is what helps you.
Yes.
Right. Yes. Even Sri Sri Ravi Shankar puts it very nicely. When you don't know about something, it is faith that takes you forward.
Exactly.
And only with faith you can take that next step.
Yes.
And that is what is important in this path. Right? So to summarize what you spoke today. So Agni, the Agni element helps you connect with the Paramatma. Right. So that is what it helps. So secondly, it also helps you purify the atmosphere around you. Like when Anand mentioned about the example of when earlier our grandmothers used to take the lamp outside the house at sunrise and sunset, that essentially purifies the environment around us, right? So that is one of the second reasons why we light a lamp. So, and also Anand mentioned about this being an experience. It would be nice if all of you
could also experience this by lighting a lamp at home. And if you really like this content and you enjoy what we are talking about, do subscribe to the Jyotishi channel. Thank you, sir.